Hi guys, today I want to show you how I tied this turban. For a number of years, I've been asked, Chaz, how do you tie your dhurmala and will you do a tutorial? Now, what's important to remember about when tying your turban or any turban is that every turban has its own personality, its own character. And when I first started tying a turban like this, because I didn't used to tie one like this, it was a bit scruffy. I was still trying to find my own way, but I think that's what the magic is. You gotta find your own style, you gotta find what suits your head, what suits your body shape, what suits your beard, what suits your ears, because I've got pretty big ears. So it's important to know when you're tying your turban for the first time, or if you're starting to tie a turban like this, you know, there will be moments where it doesn't come out right, and you know, the shape might not be the same as this right now, but every shape will differ to the person. You know, you might like a bigger turban, you might like a smaller one, you might like a longer one, you might want a shorter one. And everything's totally adaptable and customizable, I guess. When I was first taught about how to tie my dhurmala, I was shown once and I grasped the concept, but as time went on, I just kind of modified it and I found that, oh, this curve suits me a bit better. I think you're gonna find what works for you and see how you want to style yourself with your turban. So before I used to wear a turban like this, which is known as a dhurmala, I used to wear a British African style turban, which is a bit more sleek, a bit more smaller, you know, there's no creases, had sharp points, etc. And I love that style and I wore it for a number of years, but I found this style to work with me in terms of comfort, in terms of style, and in terms of me being confident. Because ultimately, I think wearing a turban for me is about confidence for you. Like, I used to struggle actually wearing a turban. I didn't enjoy wearing a turban growing up. I had to go through a few emotions and I had to kind of work my way through wearing a turban. So there might be many of you might question, how are you not comfortable with wearing a turban? You know, it's our pride, it's our joy, it's our crown. But for me, I had a different experience with it. And when I got more into my spirituality, I realized how important my hair and my turban was and is to me. So I started to experiment because I was very fascinated from a spiritual perspective and from a warrior perspective, because I was really, really interested in our history and our knowledge and the spiritual practice of Nahung Sings, as well as my yoga practice, which many of you know I do. And I can say when I started to wear a dhurmala like this, my meditation practice went through the roof and I felt more grounded and I felt more confident. For someone who actually considered cutting their hair or didn't really want to wear it out in public, or was fearing what kind of racial comments you might receive, whether you get a job or not from wearing a turban, I kind of made this turban my own, hence the decorative elements on my turban. And I really wanted to style and be a part of my turban. I didn't want the turban to be separate from me. So, you know, I think when you're going to start wearing a turban like this, or if you're going to wear a turban full stop, you want to really own it. It's kind of something that you want to make your own, style it how you want to style it, wear different colors, because now everyone is. Before we start, I just want to share with you that this is my first turban tutorial and I might make some mistakes and there might be some technical words that I might get wrong, but I want to just be as real as possible with you. Because I was inspired by one person showing me how to wear a dhurmala once. And from there, I just created my own style. But the main thing is you understanding how the technique is. And if you want to customize anything, that's totally fine. If you want to change anything, that's totally fine. I feel there is a way of how I do it. And maybe it can help you to get started. Now, without further ado, I'll teach you how I tie my dhurmala. So the first thing we want to do is create the foundation of the turban, which is known as the bunga. And this is the structural foundation. So when we tie our turban, everything ties around that, gives us the height. And again, everything's adaptable. If you've got longer hair, your bunga might be slightly longer. You can use a longer piece of cloth to make it bigger. Just so you're aware of the kind of length I'm currently using, it's just under 2 meters. And it's never the full length of the turban. This is the turban when you buy it, it's torn in half. Okay, so it's not even half a meter in width. So I grab this, tie it at the back of my head, and you're gonna wrap your hair up as if you've come out of the shower and you put a towel around your hair and you're twisting your hair into the towel. You don't want it to be too tight and you don't want it to be too loose either, okay? And on the middle of your head at the top, you should feel it right in the middle. It shouldn't be too forward, it shouldn't be too back. You're gonna now start to twist this fabric, twist this hair around the top. So it kind of feels like you've created a bit of a bun on top of your head, okay? Now I have a mirror right there, so if you see me looking to the side, it's just because I am trying my best to get this as neat as possible while explaining the process. So the next thing I do is grab my actual turban material and I place it over the bunga, okay? Grab the ends and the corners of the turban and basically wrap the other side over the ends. So one lar has gone completely round and is tucked in the ends, and now they're not loose, and you should have something like this, okay? Like this, okay? So now, with traditional smarter turbans, neater turbans, Kenyan or English turbans, the folds are done very neatly. There's a certain fold and pleating. I tried to do this with Dhrmala, but it never really worked for me. So I kind of freestyle the fold and the neatness as I go along. As you come round, you want to keep on folding the turban or the lar inside. Okay, so the outside kind of looks flat and neat, and there will be some creases, but I'll show you how to neaten that up right at the end, okay? We're gonna bring it round from the lower part of your ear, and we're gonna cross it just on the first edge of where the bunga is there at the top, okay? So it comes round. So you should have this line that comes all the way down to the center of the forehead and cuts across the end of your eyebrow and then comes down to the bottom of your earlobe. Then you're going to wrap it around the back near the top, just behind the bunga. Now you're going to make another cross going down the same way, so you'll see a point there and it covers the bottom of your ear, and you can see that it's just nipped the end of my eyebrow, okay? And it's just covering the bottom part of my ear, okay? So now at this point, your turban lar will be near the bottom. And now what we want to do is bring this to the top again, okay? So that swings to the top. And this is another step where we're going to create these half moons, okay? So I do approximately 3 or 4 depending on the thickness of the material, but for this particular material I will use 4, okay? So we made a half a moon, which kind of comes down and it goes across your forehead and then lifts back up, okay? But your hand ends up back where it started at the top. And then we do another half moon, again folding in all the lars, making it look neat-ish, as neat as possible, okay? And now we do another lar that comes just above the first one, okay? Maybe with about a centimeter gap. And then we take it up and it meets just where the back is again. So we're going from high to low. Now at this stage, you might be questioning, hey Chaz, this kind of looks a mess, or I'm totally not getting it. I think you're gonna have to feel a lot with your hands, because I couldn't see the back of my head naturally because I haven't got eyes at the back of my head. So a lot of what I did and how I created my style or turban was really by feeling and knowing whether the pleats are right, whether there's a lot of stuff coming out of the sides, whether it's sitting well. So a lot of mine was feel, and if you have access to a mirror behind you, that always helps as well. Or actually, if you've got a friend or a partner or a girlfriend, they'll definitely help you because they don't want to be, hanging around with someone who's got a messy bug. As the next lud comes around, we call it the final lud, okay? There should be four now. One, two, three, four. After we've done the fourth lud, we're going to bring it round to the kind of middle of the head at the back, okay? Now we're going to go into the next step where we want to kind of reverse what we were doing from the bottom, now going from the top, okay? So these are like heels we're making, okay? So it goes round the top and over. And now we're going lower and lower at the back each time we go round. And at the top, your bunga, make sure it's staying in place. Different fabrics might react a bit different. Some might slip, some might be quite firm, some might be thick. So you want to maybe be just tucking it in as you go along and make sure it's looking neat and tidy. But again, you can do all of this right at the end, okay? So we're going to continue going round. So I think this might be my third. And from the back, it's now going lower and high. And what you're trying to do is see this line there now? We're trying to cut it from the bottom to the top and then back round. Low again. And then back high. Okay, for the final lud. And you can see that we have some kind of shape, we've got some structure, and it was all done in one motion, one piece of fabric. I've seen some people do turbans with two pieces of fabric. I've done that in the past as well. That's a bit more trickier, and it can be sometimes less neater as well, but this is really easy. With this last part, you can cut it once you've got your desired length, but I've already pre-cut this one. And this tucks in right here. In some of them, you might want to cut and place right at the back of the neck, or some of them you might want to do here. For preference, I've always just had it here. And then you just adjust and kind of shape how you want your turban to look. Again, a lot of mine is with feel, so I can feel that it's a bit loose on the bunga, so I'm tucking that in. I don't usually use a salai. I actually use a spoon. But if I do, it's usually just to put my hair in from the back or tighten and neaten some of these folds. So to finish up, we have a trusted salai for this demonstration. Okay. Now, what you might want to do, and I'll come a bit closer for you here, is that you might want to just neaten up some of these folds where there might be a few creases. You just use a salai. Tuck these in, make the folds nice and tight. You might want to tuck these bits that are just kind of bulging out, maybe, or puffed up. Again, do the same there. Now, when you've got more time and the more practice you have with tying your dirmallah, this will become second nature. Because I'm doing it on camera and I'm trying to do a live demonstration and tutorial, it's a bit tricky. I didn't realize it was actually going to be as hard as this, and it wasn't done with any grace. So my sincere apologies. So just neatening up everything at the top using your salai. I'm just tucking in like loose fabric around the edge. And I'm feeling at the bottom, I can feel that I have like steps going back to the bottom. Okay, so that's from the sides. What I can do is to make sure everything is like nice and tidy, I'll just press out any kind of loose or gathered fabric and bring it to the front and distribute it around the head. So you just want to really smarten it up using all your tools, your salai and your hand, And to be honest, your eye, you just want to really make sure you like it, how it looks. You can make it bigger and longer if you add more material to the bunga. You can have a bigger turban, obviously, if you add more meterage, or you can have it smaller. But for me, this is what works for me, and I like it. It's comfortable, it's practical for me, and it looks cool as hell. I love the color. If you have any questions, feel free to DM me or message in the comments below, and I'd love to hear how you got on with this tutorial. Did it help? Are you not wearing a dermala? Are you looking to start wearing a dermala? Are you a pro dermala expert and you want to share some things with me? Maybe I've got some of the terminology wrong, so again, apologies for that. For the piece de la resistance is my feathers and shingara. Now, the reason I wear a shingara with some feathers, it is something that's very personal to me. I wanted to celebrate wearing a turban for myself because it was another milestone in my life. Whereas I'd always worn a turban as a child, but when I started wearing a turban like this, I wanted to decorate, I wanted to celebrate a moment in my life where I really embraced wearing a turban. I really understood what it means. I really understood why spiritual practices have turbans and why spiritual people have long hair. When I put it in my dermala, I really loved how it came out. It became a kind of an identity for me, and I think everything that you want to do with your turban is okay, as long as it helps you with confidence and you feel content and it's real and it's original to you, then there's no harm. I hope you liked the tutorial, and if it's beneficial for you, please leave a comment below, like, and please subscribe to the YouTube channel so I can create more videos like this, help you answer your questions, and help people who are trying to find their confidence, their spiritual wisdom, and connect to themselves. And until next time, peace out. Naturally, you got to do that every time you wear your dermala or tie your dermala. It's a standard thing, isn't it?